racism in America. New York Daily News has an article about a guy just this weekend. Yeah, I gotta find that one actually. That would be great. Oh God, here's the New Yorker. I'll tell you about the New Yorker. The Atlanta shooting and the dehumanizing of Asian women. But they weren't focused on it. They were focused about how to fix problems and use a platform. New York Daily News article, what's the date on this? March 21st, yesterday. Listen carefully. Man, this is the headline. Man in critical condition after unprovoked punch on Manhattan subway. Latest victim of anti-Asian hate. Guess what? The unprovoked punch came from a black guy. Never mentioned in the article. There's a picture of the guy in the article. So if you read the headline, everybody assumes all whatever anti-Asian hate there is, it's disproportionately from blacks. That's a fact. Not an attack. Not a critique. The lying New York Times, the lying CNN, they lie and they lie and they lie again, and they manufacture hysteria because if Americans get along, the left dies. Get it? They provoke hate. The left is a hate machine. Get that clear? That's what it is. It's a hate machine. So they manufacture hatred. They manufacture victimization to perpetuate what they manufacture. And let's see. Then I have, raised this issue about vaccines. Clearly, if you take Fauci and the others seriously, it's the least effective vaccine ever developed in history. You have to wear a mask after you take it, and you're not immune to the next guy who didn't take it. Why do you care if anybody else took it if the vaccine works? Did you care if other people took a flu shot or a smallpox shot? You're going to get smallpox if you took. What's the point of a smallpox vaccine? It's to protect you from smallpox. I took a yellow fever shot about four times in my life. Every 10 years, you're supposed to take it if you go to a place like Africa. Why? Because you don't get the disease. That's the point of a vaccine. We live in a world of lies, including the corrupted medical establishment, which I wrote about. You should all read it. I should put it up again. There's a good one. Natasha, Mansfield, Texas. Hello, Natasha.
Hi.
Hi. Your turn.
Oh, okay. So, first of all, I love your show.
Great.
I've never talked on the radio ever. And your Gladiator song that you play, The Battle, I love that soundtrack so much that I have been playing that in the background while I was giving birth.
Thank you.
have helped urban communities too much. The heavy hand of government to the great...
I never used to be there. Hey, it's Death Hill. Yeah. Oh, look at the golden kitty.